Hey, sweetie. How are you? Did you have a good day today? That's good. Yeah, I'm tired too. My yoga class was amazing today. I've been doing yoga now consistently for about 2 years now, so I'm excited to see where it goes, what opportunities lie ahead. I'm really wanting to create yoga videos, maybe yoga for beginners. What do you think about that? I'm pretty confident I could do at least yoga for beginners. I'm pretty confident with that. I'm not sure if I would consider myself a yogi or not, but I do know a lot of the poses, and like I said, I feel pretty confident that I could create a video. So yeah, I had a really, really, really nice time during my meditation today as well. It was so beautiful. And I know you're working really hard on meditating and trying out yoga. And I know that you have a lot going on. However, you just telling me that you're going to try all these little things really, really makes me happy. And it's so good for you. I wouldn't continue telling you these things if it wasn't good for us. I just want to try to help you continue to clear your mind. That's all. I am so tired. We're gonna sleep so good. Yes, we are. Anything else you want to tell me about your day? That's interesting. Anything new that you learned? Any crazy encounter? I love when things just work out as they should. It's a beautiful thing when we can go about our days flowing, going with the flow, leaning into what feels good, and how everything works out. Everything gets done. Everything works out. And I've noticed too here lately that when you just go with the flow, things just work out perfectly. Stretching before bed. These yoga pants are so soft. And I know they're your favorite, so I like to wear them a lot. Do you like this purple one better or the blue one? You like this one better? I can't really decide. I like both equally. Have you read any new books lately? I know you said that you've been wanting to, broaden your horizons and try to create new habits that are good for our brains. You haven't yet? Oh, it's fine. It's fine. I'm actually rereading a book that I read several months ago. I feel like the first time I read it, I gained a lot of knowledge, but I'm not sure if it actually sat with me and I fully understand. So I'm rereading it, and I'm reading it slower, and I'm actually taking my time to really understand what I'm reading. So I'm really excited for that. I used to not like to reread books that I've read in the past because I thought it would be a waste of time. But it's actually, I don't think it's a waste of time at all, especially if it's information and knowledge that you really want to retain. I think it's wonderful to continue to go back and try to, maybe relearn it or learn it in a new way, in a more deeper way than ever before. So that's what I'm doing. I'm actually reading a few books. At a time. So I read this one, The Four Agreements. I read this one, I read this one not too long ago. Honestly, I'm gonna have to reread it because I don't quite remember it. I know that's terrible, and I don't know why it's like that. Like, when I read a book, I can be fully immersed. I don't know if this happens to you, but I can be fully immersed in a book, read it cover to cover, and then when I ask myself, or if someone asks me about the book, I can't tell them a single thing. And sometimes I think, okay, something's wrong with me, but I know I'm not the only one. Anyway, so in this book, in The Four Agreements, Don Miguel Ruiz reveals the source of self-limiting beliefs that rob us of joy and create needless suffering. Based on ancient Toltec wisdom, The Four Agreements offer a powerful code of conduct that can rapidly transform our lives to a new experience of freedom, true happiness, and love. An inspiring book with many great lessons. So I have this book if you want to start off with something pretty simple. As less than 140 pages, so might want to give this one a try. Maybe this could be a good bathroom read. I could put this in the bathroom. And then I have this book, which is called The Lives of a Cell. I haven't started it yet. I've read like one page. And this literally just talks about the lives of a cell, the cells within our body. So I think it's amazing, and I cannot wait to finish this one, or to even start that one. And I'm also reading this book, A Discovery of Witches, which I'm on page 131. This is a pretty good fiction novel. It's about witches and vampires and daemons. I say daemon because that's how the writer spells demon, D-A-E-M-O-N. So I can't help but to say daemon every time I read the word demon. Daemon. I'm not sure. Anyways, it's a pretty good book. Normally, I'll read this when I've accomplished all of my work for the day. And this book is like a little reward. It's like a little fantasy romance. You know, it's getting pretty spicy. So this is my fun go-to book. An Irresistible Tale of Wizardry, Science, and Forbidden Love. So, that one's fun. I'm not sure if you'd be interested in reading that one or not. And then You Are the Placebo by Dr. Joe Dispenza. I've read a couple of his books. Becoming Supernatural, which that's the one I'm rereading right now. Becoming Supernatural. And I think it's Mind Over Matter. However, this one is brilliant. The stories in this book, they're just mind-blowing. And if you have never heard of Dr. Joe Dispenza, you can Google him. He is fantastic. Oh, well, you've heard me talk about Dr. Joe Dispenza before. I was just, whenever I came across him, a few years actually, I came across Dr. Joe Dispenza a few years ago, actually. I was just so intrigued by him and amazed at his story in general. Basically, Dr. Joe Dispenza, he had fractured his spine. I believe it was... Anyways, he had fractured his spine. Or I think he actually broke his spine. His spinal column. I think it was the C1 and C2, I don't know. Anyways, he broke his spine in a bicycle accident, and he was pretty much left to the choice of, you know, you're going to be in pain forever with all of these rods and metal in your body, or pretty much you're not going to make it. And he wouldn't have that. So he searched and searched and searched, and he literally healed himself within 6 weeks just by rewiring our brains and our thought patterns and fully believing in healing himself. And he did. So it's just amazing. I suggest this book. Obviously, you may not be interested in it, so don't worry about it. You'll hear it from me anyways. And I'm also reading The Reiki for Everyday Living, which is so amazing to me and magical. And I highly do believe in the power of touch, of healing touch. So I'm excited to learn about Reiki. Discover how to transform your life through the power of Reiki. Reiki is very easy to learn and can be used to heal every aspect of our lives. We can administer Reiki to ourselves and to others. It is a practice that cures ills, soothes emotions, and enables us to create the life that we want. Yeah, so I'm super excited. So we'll see. I haven't been too inspired by my books lately. I feel like I've been reading the same genres, I guess you could say, for a long period of time. And I just, for some reason, I can't step out and read something that's just totally off the wall. I do have a couple mangas that I need to read, but I stopped reading those too. I don't know, sometimes I just get uninspired by the books that I have. The other day I actually cleaned out a bunch of the books on my bookshelf, and I took it to the local bookstore and put it in the free bin. I mean, there were books that I never even read before. Really good book, so I do hope someone picked them out of the free bin. I hope I didn't talk your ear off about nothing, practically. And I'm hungry, too. Are you hungry? You just want to go to sleep, I know. Well, just relax. Just relax. Glad you invited me over. Hold on, you got something right here. Okay. You had something on your face. I got it. I hope you sleep well. You have something right here in your face. Let me get that. There we go. Your hair smells really nice. You okay, sweetie? Relax, baby, relax. I want you to go to sleep. I hope you sleep well and you have good dreams. Tomorrow's gonna be a fantastic day. You're gonna wake up, we're gonna be feeling good, we're gonna be productive. Everything's gonna be just fine. Everything's gonna be just fine. Everything works out. Just continue doing you, and everything will be just fine.